Hello and good morning to one and all. Am I audible to you? Okay, good morning. Okay, very good. Thank you. Okay, so we will start today's session of operating system and administration. Okay, I hope that today onwards the link will be available on the LMS. Okay, and after the completion of this session, again you have to give your attendance on the LMS itself. Okay, so I think that all you are familiar with the LMS, okay, learning management system, LMS platform that is widely used from last semester for online session in our college. So after the completion of this session, kindly mark your attendance in the LMS attendance for today's session, for today's date. Okay, all things are already I have implemented there. I have configured all the attendance for all the sessions. So you just want to click there and mark your attendance. Okay, so we will continue from our yesterday's session. Yesterday, if you remember, we were in the article of user's perspective. So can anybody tell me what are the high level features of Unix operating systems? What are the high level features of Unix operating systems? Mainly there are three things in the high level features of Unix operating systems. Can anybody share or can anybody tell what are the three high level features of Unix operating systems? Meanwhile, I will share the PPT. Okay. Okay, Shraddha is saying the first one is the file system, exactly correct. Then second one is the processing environment, and last one is the building block primitive, exactly right. Correct, very good. Yes, so these three are the very important high level features of Unix operating system. Okay, the file system, then the processing environment, and last one is the basic building blocks or basic building primitives. So already we completed the file systems. Okay, many more things we discussed there in the file systems. So this is the three high level features of Unix operating system. First one is the file system, second one is the processing environment, and last one is the building block primitives. So what is the file system? That also we discussed yesterday. Okay, so the Unix file system is characterized by, or again somebody can ask you that, what are the features of Unix file system? Okay, somebody can ask in the examination, in the practical examination, in the theory examination, that tell me what are the features of Unix file systems. So then also you can say that the Unix file system is hierarchical in nature, or the structure of the Unix file system is hierarchical. Unix file systems provide the consistent treatment on file data. Okay. Third one is the Unix file system is having the ability to create and delete the files. And Unix file system is responsible for dynamic growth of the files. Unix file system provides the protection to the file data. And Unix file system treat the peripheral devices as a file. So these are some of the highlighted characteristics of the Unix file systems. Then also there are important points, like there is a root node. Okay, every file systems or the it's a tree structure. So you have to draw a figure of Unix file system. This is a sample file system tree where root node is shown along with the directories as a non-leaf node and leaf node as a file. So at leaf node there may be a special device file, regular file, or sometimes it is a directory. So yesterday we have cleared all the things about the file systems. Okay, then after this related to the file system, these three important points, again you can call it as the features or characteristics, like how the program treats the file systems. Okay, so the program in the Unix is not having any knowledge about the internal format of the data which is stored in the file. It treats the data as an unformatted stream of bytes. Okay, this is a very important point related to the file systems. Then second point is the directories are treated as the regular files. Okay, if we are saying that the directories are the regular file, then the system treats the data in the directory as a byte stream. Okay, and third characteristic is that the permission to access the file is controlled by access permission associated with the file. Okay, so how many access permissions are associated with the file? Our first is how many types of users are there in Unix? How many types of users are there in a Unix file system? Yesterday we concluded 3 types of users. Very good, correct. What are the types of users? Which one is the first user? Which one is the first user? The first user is file owner, correct. Second one is group owner. Second one is group owner, and third one is other. Absolutely right. Okay, very good. So this is very important point that every file is having 3 types of user. First one is the owner of the file. Second one is the group owner of the file, and third one is the other user. Then as far as this access permission is concerned, there are 3 types of access permission given to the files. Okay, so what are that 3 types of access permission given to the file? Read, write, and execute. Correct. Very good. So read, write, and execute are the 3 access permission associated with each file. So kindly remember these things, because same things we will see in the practical sessions. Whenever the actual execution of the program, shell script, Java program, C programs, Python programs will start, where all these things we will discuss. And there probably you will understand these things practically, that what are the 3 types of users, how they are getting the access for reading, writing, and executing the files. Suppose you want to change the access rights of other user. Okay, kabhi kabhi aapko aisa lagta hai ki, yes, I want to give the access right to my friend for execution of this file, so that you can change the access right of that user by using the Linux command. So there are commands like chmod is the command which is used to change the mode, that is nothing but the permission to access the file. Okay, so various commands are there for performing these activities. Okay, so this also we discussed yesterday. So I will change the slide. These are the 3 some of the points, highlighted points of the file systems. So whenever the file system, आपको कभी भी फाइल सिस्टम के बारे में कुछ क्वेश्चन या फिर आपको कुछ आंसर लिखना है, तो आपको इन पॉइंट्स को हाईलाइट करना पड़ेगा. लाइक देयर इज अ रूट नोड इन द फाइल सिस्टम व्हिच इज शोन बाय द स्लैश व्हिच इज द रूट ऑफ द फाइल सिस्टम्स. ओके, देन देयर आर नॉन लीफ नोड व्हिच आर नथिंग बट द डायरेक्टरीज ऑफ द फाइल्स. देन देयर आर लीफ नोड व्हिच कैन बी अ डायरेक्टरीज और रेगुलर फाइल्स और द स्पेशल डिवाइस फाइल. Then there is a path name. Every file name is accessed by using path name by Unix file system. And path name is what? Path name is the sequence of components separated by the slash. And a component is the sequence of character designates a file name that is uniquely contained in the previous directory components. So that definition of the path name yesterday I have given in the chat box. Okay. Same thing is available in the textbooks also, so that you can easily get from the textbook. But remember, what is the path name? Path name ka use kya hai ki for user we are saying that my program name is matrix.c. okay, I can say that my program name is matrix.c, but for operating system, whenever the operating system wants to access the file, that time the operating system wants a path name. Okay, and the path name, that is nothing but the sequence of characters separated by slash, and the sequence of components separated by slash, and the component is the sequence of character that designate a file name that is uniquely contained in the previous directory. So then the current directory is there. Current directory, I said that whenever we are working in a current in any directory. Okay, like for example, your path name is like this slash etc slash usr, then your current directory is usr. आप किस डायरेक्टरी में काम कर रहे हैं, That is nothing but current directory. Sometimes it is also called as PWD. PWD stand for present working directory. Okay, that is the command in the Linux operating systems. Then directories, we know access permission. I said that there are three types of access permission along with three types of the user. Okay, so this thing we have discussed. And then there is a sample program, copy program. This also we will discuss in more detail in the practical session, how to perform the copy of old file into the new file. Okay, so this is a C program under a Unix platform where it shows that how to contain the copy of old file into the new file. Okay, right now you don't bother about the syntax and semantics and all these commands or the primitives which are used there. I will explain all these things in detail once in the practical session. We start our programming, and then in the next session we will, after completion of your Linux commands, I will start our shell script programming and C programming. So now this is the one of the topic, processing environment, that is second high level features of Unix operating systems, where you can see the some of the highlighted points are there. मैंने अगर प्रोग्राम बनाया तो मैं उसको नाम देता हूँ matrix.c. तो आप जब प्रोग्राम बनाते थे तो matrix.c फॉर एग्जाम्पल इज अ फाइल टू द यूनिक्स. ओके, यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम ट्रीट्स दैट प्रोग्राम एज अ फाइल. ओके, सो दिस थिंग इज रिटन देयर, द यूनिक्स ट्रीट अ प्रोग्राम एज जस्ट अ फाइल. ओके, वंस योर प्रोग्राम इज कंप्लीटेड एंड यू सेव दैट प्रोग्राम, वेन एवर वी कंपाइल दैट प्रोग्राम and it becomes a executable file. Ye bhi cheez aapko second line aap ppt mein dekh sakte hain. Whenever the program is compiled, the program becomes a executable file. Third line, if you see, what is the third line? Whenever the program is actually running, that time the program is called as process. So yahan pe main आपको कल भी मैंने डेफिनेशन बताई थी कि व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द प्रोसेस. तो आपको याद रखना है, प्रोसेस इज द इंस्टेंस ऑफ प्रोग्राम व्हिच इज इन एग्जीक्यूशन. प्रोसेस इज द इंस्टेंस ऑफ एग्जीक्यूटिव प्रोग्राम, करेक्ट? ओके, एब्सोल्युटली राइट. ओके, सो आदिति हैज गिवन द स्टेटमेंट दैट द प्रोसेस इज द इंस्टेंस ऑफ एग्जीक्यूटिव प्रोग्राम, और रादर यू कैन चेंज द सेंटेंस लाइक दिस, प्रोसेस इज द इंस्टेंस ऑफ प्रोग्राम which is in execution. So I will write here. Okay, here. Process is the instance of program which is in execution. So wherever you go, till your completion of your graduation or after the completion of your graduation, the process is very important. जो कुछ अगर मैंने आपको सिंपल लैंग्वेज में कहा कि व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस, दैट मींस, ओके, दिस मींस दैट द जो कुछ एग्जीक्यूट हो रहा है दैट इज कॉल्ड एज प्रोसेस. ओके, इसीलिए आपने अगर चैट बॉक्स में देखा, द प्रोसेस इज द इंस्टेंस ऑफ प्रोग्राम व्हिच इज इन एग्जीक्यूशन. दिस स्टेटमेंट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इंस्टेंस मतलब प्रोसेस, इट इज हैविंग नंबर ऑफ इंस्टेंसेस. इंस्टेंसेस मतलब क्या रहता है कि आप जब प्रोग्राम एग्जीक्यूट करते हैं तो द फर्स्ट इंस्टेंस दैट इनपुट द नंबर, इनपुट हाउ मेनी रोज एंड कॉलम, द फर्स्ट इंस्टेंस. सेकंड, देन इन एंटर एक्चुअल एलिमेंट इन द मैट्रिक्स. एंड थर्ड, देन परफॉर्म द मैट्रिक्स मल्टीप्लीकेशन. लास्ट, डिस्प्ले द रिजल्ट. सो देर आर डिफरेंट इंस्टेंस ऑफ द प्रोग्राम विच आर इन एग्जीक्यूशन, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द प्रोसेस. तो हमेशा आपको याद रखना है कि जो कुछ एग्जीक्यूट हो रहा है उसे प्रोसेस कहते हैं. तो अगर मैंने अलग लैंग्वेज में आपको बताया तो प्रोसेस हमेशा एग्जीक्यूट मोड में रहती है. प्रोसेस इज ऑलवेज इन रनिंग मोड. ओके, ये जो कुछ मैं ओरली आपको बता रहा हूं ये आपको अच्छी तरह से कॉन्सेंट्रेशन देकर सुनना है, याद रखना है कि जो कुछ आप एग्जीक्यूट कर रहे हैं उसे प्रोसेस कहते हैं. ओके, वॉट एवर इज इन एग्जीक्यूशन दैट इज नथिंग बट द प्रोसेस. एंड वॉट एवर इज स्टोर्ड ऑन द डिस्क दैट इज कॉल्ड एज फाइल. ओके, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज फाइल. वॉट एवर इज स्टोर्ड ऑन द डिस्क दैट इज कॉल्ड एज फाइल. and whatever is in execution, that is called as process. तो अलग और एक इंफॉर्मेशन मैं देना चाहता हूँ यहाँ पे कि प्रोसेस, और मैं क्वेश्चन पूछता हूँ आपका, आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क द क्वेश्चन दैट प्रोसेस इज अ एक्टिव एंटिटी और पैसिव एंटिटी, व्हाट इज योर ओपिनियन? प्रोसेस इज अ एक्टिव एंटिटी और पैसिव एंटिटी, करेक्ट? वेरी गुड. प्रोसेस इज अ एक्टिव एंटिटी, करेक्ट? एब्सोल्युटली राइट. मीन्स once we are saying that the process is always in execution, that means the process is a active entity. Okay, ye aapko hamesha yaad rakhna hai. And opposite to that, the file is the passive entity. File which is stored on the disk, that is a passive entity. Okay, and the process is the active entity. To ye aapko difference samajh mein aana chahiye. Because we are learning here the Unix operating system. So, आपको Unix के बारे में मतलब process, files, all these things are very important for each and every operating system that we must know what is mean by file. तो आपको कई ये भी समझ में आएगा कि what is mean by file. So file is the active passive entity, whereas the process is the active entity which is always in execution. Got it? So we will move towards the next point where one example is shown on your screen, and that example is here. For example, when the user requests that the program to be run in the Unix must load the program from executable file on the disk where it is resides. Okay, so your program matrix.c is stored on the disk, and once you want to run the program, that means you want to brought that program from disk to the primary memory. So that is a usual operation that is not only happens with Unix but with happens with all operating system. Whenever the program is in execution, that program first of all brought from secondary storage device to the primary memory. So that is written there. So once the program brought into the memory, then it builds the appropriate data structure to keep the track of that program as it runs. Now what are the data structure? So two things are very important right now that you must understand. One is the user stack and second one is the kernel stack. Okay, I will explain all these things detail later on. Ye sab kuch aane wala hai aapke syllabus mein yahan pe, what is mean by user stack and what is mean by kernel stack. That are the two important data structure. Jab aapka program aap primary memory mein laate hai, so there are user stack and kernel stack. So it builds the appropriate data structure to run the program. Okay, then what happens, then a process is just a data structure in which Unix keeps all the information about the status of the program that is running. So that kernel stack and the user stack, okay, kernel, remember the word kernel stack and the user stack. In this two stack, the status of the program which is in execution, that all status is stored. This work will be done by the kernel itself, Unix itself. Okay, so that is some of the features or characteristics of processes in the Unix. So yahan pe aapko kya yaad rakhna hai, yahan pe aapko teen cheeze yaad rakhni hai. First one is what is mean by process, what is mean by program, what is mean by file, what are the characteristics of process, then how the process is executing, what happens when the program is brought from primary secondary memory to the primary memory. Okay, so whatever the paragraph is there on your screen, that has given all the things in details. Okay, next paragraph, if you see, that is also related with the process creation in the Unix. Now see, my dear student, once you create the file, okay, abhi aapko understand karne ke liye main aapko simple language mein batata hu. आपने matrix.c प्रोग्राम क्रिएट किया, matrix.c प्रोग्राम इज क्रिएटेड एंड दैट इज स्टोर्ड ऑन द सेकेंडरी स्टोरेज डिवाइस हार्ड डिस्क, एंड नाउ यू वांट टू रन द प्रोग्राम. अभी आपको प्रोग्राम अगर रन करना है तो क्या होता है देखो, तो वेन एवर द प्रोग्राम यू वांट टू एग्जीक्यूट, देन इट बिकम्स अ प्रोसेस एज पर आवर प्रोटोकॉल. As per the protocol of Unix operating system, the program become process. So yahan pe process management is the very important features of Unix operating system that plays into action. And that process management kya karta hai? Process management create the process. Internally the process is created. अभी आपको सिर्फ इतना ही याद रखना है कि whenever the program is in execution, that is called as process. तो ये कैसे होगा? So process creation will take place. Okay? ये आपको नहीं करना है. आपको as a end user कुछ भी काम नहीं करना है. आपने program run किया, compile किया, run किया, तो process automatically काम करना क्रिएट करने का काम कौन करने वाला है? यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम करने वाला है. तो इसे हम क्या कहते हैं? प्रोसेस क्रिएशन. तो आपको अभी आपके मन में डाउट आएगा, क्वेश्चन आएगा कि हाउ यूनिक्स गोइंग टू क्रिएट द प्रोसेस. यस और नो? हाउ द प्रोसेस आर गोइंग टू क्रिएट इंटरनली. मेरा प्रोग्राम का नाम क्या है? मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी. तो प्रोसेस कैसे क्रिएट होगी? दैट इज अ गुड क्वेश्चन. So here, internally, Unix is having number of system calls. तो यहाँ पे अभी आपको मैंने और एक नई चीज बताई, system call. ये भी चीज आपको हमेशा याद रखनी है, system call. तो what is a system call? System call का मतलब रहता है, अगर simple language में कहा तो that is a function. यूनिक्स में बहुत सारे ऐसे फंक्शंस रहते हैं, उसे सिस्टम कॉल्स कहते हैं. सिस्टम कॉल्स की डेफिनेशन क्या है? सिस्टम कॉल इज लाइक अ ऑर्डिनरी सी फंक्शन विच रिटर्न सम वैल्यू. सी लैंग्वेज में आप फंक्शन लिखते हैं, आपने लिखा होगा, फर्स्ट ईयर में लिखा होगा, फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर में लिखा होगा, आपके डेटा स्ट्रक्चर लैबोरेटरी में. तो यहाँ पे फंक्शन क्या रहता है? फंक्शन को एक नाम रहता है. Function is having the name, function is having the parameter, function is having the body of the statement, function returns something. Yes or no? So similarly, Unix mein internally bahut sare system calls rehte. A system call is like a ordinary C function which is having a name, which is having a parameter, which is having a body of statement, and every system call return a value. समझ में आया? ये सिस्टम कॉल भी आपको प्रैक्टिकल इंप्लीमेंटेशन के दौरान बहुत बार यूज करना है. तो सिस्टम कॉल मतलब इट इज अ वेरी हैंडी, आई मीन इट इज अ डिफॉल्ट रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन अ यूनिक्स एंड सिस्टम कॉल. सिस्टम कॉल के सिवा आप प्रोग्राम नहीं बना सकते. समझ में आया आपको? विदाउट सिस्टम कॉल यू कैनॉट अंडरस्टैंड द यूनिक्स, you cannot execute the program in a Unix platform. तो यहाँ पे एक चीज दिखाई दे, read the statement. Process creation हमारा टॉपिक चल रहा था, process creation. So how to create the process in Unix? So there is a system call fork, F-O-R-K, fork system call. Got it? You can see there is, I have written there, the fork system call. What is the fork? Fork is a system call that is used to create the child process. Child process. Okay. Yeah, both interesting, Abhi. This thing is new to you. But this is a worldwide standard that Unix create a child process by using fork system call. Okay. Fork. F-O-R-K. Fork system call. तो आपके मन में सवाल आएगा, सर चाइल्ड प्रोसेस कहां से आया आपने, मतलब बीच में चाइल्ड प्रोसेस का मतलब क्या है? तो सी, चाइल्ड प्रोसेस मतलब जब भी नई प्रोसेस आप क्रिएट करते हैं, आप मतलब ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, व्हेनेवर द यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम क्रिएट द न्यू प्रोसेस, दिस प्रोसेस इज नथिंग बट द चाइल्ड प्रोसेस. तभी आपके मन में ख्याल आएगा कि सर चाइल्ड प्रोसेस इज देयर, तो पेरेंट प्रोसेस भी कुछ रहती है क्या? यस, पेरेंट प्रोसेस विल क्रिएट द चाइल्ड प्रोसेस. समझ में आया आपको? तो बाय डिफॉल्ट पेरेंट क्या रहेगा? बाय डिफॉल्ट व्हाट इज द पेरेंट इन यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम? कोई जजमेंट लगा सकता है क्या? कैन जज और कैन यू कैन गिव द आंसर अकॉर्डिंग टू योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. व्हाट विल बी द डिफॉल्ट पेरेंट इन द Prathamesh is saying that it is the original program. Original program means your program is matrix.c that become a parent. Okay. My question, you first of all try to understand. My question is that in Unix, by default, underline the word by default. In Unix, by default, who is a parent? Take your own time. Think yourself that what will be the default parent in the Unix operating system? I think something is written by, let me read it. Siddhant is saying that, I think that OS itself is the parent process. Again, I am not getting the expected answer. OS means what? Kernel. Now Akshay is on the track. Okay, kernel. Okay. Think yourself other than this. Kernel, you are on the track. Siddhant and Akshay, both are on the track to give the correct answer. But again, we not got the expect answer. What is the default process management? Process management is the unit. Process management is the unit. We are responsible for creation and deletion and the execution of the process. That unit is different. Okay, process management. Correct, very good. Akshay is giving the correct answer. Root node. Instead of file, you must have the root process. Root process is the by default parent in the Unix operating system. Correct, very good. Don't call it as a file. Abhi maine bataya aapko ki jo kuch execution mein hai, use process kehte. File is a passive entity. So you can say root process. I will write here. Okay. Root process is the by default parent in the Unix. Root. Correct. Very good. Yes, Arjun. You have given the correct notation. Root. Root is the default process in the Unix operating system. समझ में आ रहा है आप सबको? Are you getting what I am saying? This is very important because ये आपको समझ में आना चाहिए कि what is the internal structure of the Unix operating system, what are its meaning, and how we can proceed with all these things. Okay, so. Okay, so now you come to know that what is a root process. Root process is the first process. Root process is the default parent process. Samajh mein aaya aapko? Root process is the default parent process. So whatever is the remaining process are creating, that are the child process. Root jisko create karega, that become a child process. Samajh mein aaya aapko? Okay, samajh mein aaya? Root process will create the child process. Root process will create the child process. How it will create the child process? By using the system called fork, f-o-r-k, fork. Okay, so suppose root process create a child process, uska naam maine diya child one. Okay, chat box mein dekho, child one, okay, is the newly process, is the new process. Now who is the parent of this process? Who is the parent of this process? Root. Correct. Very good. Okay. Okay. Root is the parent of this process. Now, you keep in mind, child one can also create a new child process, new process, and also create a new process. Okay, this is very interesting. Child one can also create a new process using fork system call. You all of you see the chat box I have written there. Okay. Very soon we are going to start the physical education from 15th. Very soon you will get the notice. Then we will write these things on the your blackboard or green board. Okay. So right now we are writing here in the chat box that child one can also create the new process using fork system call. ये स्टेटमेंट आपको समझ में आया? तो चाइल्ड वन ने अगर प्रोसेस क्रिएट की तो उसका नाम हम देते हैं चाइल्ड टू. चाइल्ड टू इज द न्यू प्रोसेस. चाइल्ड टू इज द न्यू प्रोसेस. नाउ माय क्वेश्चन इज दैट हु इज द पेरेंट ऑफ चाइल्ड टू? चाइल्ड वन. करेक्ट. वेरी गुड. सो लाइक दिस इट इज कंटिन्यूइंग. व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू एक्सप्लेन, the fork system call can use to create the new child process. Every time a new child process will be created by fork system call. Okay, samajh mein aaya aapko? To ye aapko processing, hamara topic ka naam kya hai? Processing environment. Isme aapko process ke bare mein ye jo iske jo characteristics hai, features hai, ye aapko samajh mein aana chahiye. So very important that process, then its execution, data structure, and now the process creation, fork system call. Now you can read the last statement. In order to begin understand how Unix deals with process, one must learn how Unix create the process in the first place. That is, how does Unix start a program in an executable file on disk? We use the following two sample codes to discuss it. Okay, एक code, एक program भी आपको मैं दिखाने वाला हूँ कि जहाँ पे आपको ये actually कैसे create होता है समझ में आएगा. So that statement is very important. In order to begin understanding of how Unix deals with process, one must learn how Unix create the processes. So now there will be a very important information, and question is that how to create the process in Unix? There will be a question in examination. How the process, child process, is created in the Unix? Which system call is used to create the child process? Which system call is used to create the child process? So, aapka answer kya aayega? Aapka answer aana chahiye. Fork system call. Fork system call, yes, fork, F. Always write the F in the small case. F, like this. I will write here. Fork, okay, here. Fork. This is the correct way to write the fork system call. Opening bracket and the closing bracket. Opening bracket and the closing bracket. That means it is a, why we write the opening bracket and closing bracket? What is the syntax? What is this? This is a system call, and we know that system call is like a function which is having the name, which is having the parameter, which is having the body of statement, and which returns something. That's why we are writing this opening bracket and closing bracket instead of every system call. आगे जाकर मैं आपको बहुत सारे system call बताने वाला हूँ. बहुत सारे number of system call. Total maximum 64 system calls are there. And more than 32 system calls are widely used in Unix. समझ में आया आपको? So that's why it is a function. System call is like a ordinary C function, which is having a name, which is having a parameter, which is having a body of statement, and which returns something. That is a formal definition. Formal means this is the definition, so that you can remember what do you mean by system call. So very first system call that you learn today is fork system call. Abhi bhi iske bare mein mujhe aapko kuch information batani hai. So let's change the slide here.
Here, yes, something is there also. Okay, here, this is the figure actually. This is the figure that we are going to learn and understand. The program to create the new process. Okay, how to create the new process? That is the program. Okay, so first of all, we will see something about this process creation here. Jo copy ka program tha, copy the content of old file into the new file. Copy the content of old file into the new file. That program also contains some of the process creation task and the system calls here. So that's why with reference to that program, okay, we must call various function in order to do the task that requiring accessing hardware and are therefore only available through services provided by the operating system. So that program I will open here. See, this is that program where you can see the printf, then the exit, okay, then copy, then while. All these are the functions. Main is the important function. So with reference to this program, what we are saying that the program must call various function in order to do the tasks that require accessing hardware and are therefore only available through process provided by the operating system. And what are these functions? Like the printf is there, exit is there, and the open are all the example of such calls. Okay, so internally the functions accessed by these calls must have in their machine language form the equivalent trap instruction which does the actual call to the Unix system service in the question. Okay, so with reference to this figure, see this figure, there are printf, exit, and open. All these are nothing but the function that calls something. Okay, you know the importance of function in the data structure. This calls something. So that information is given here. Again, now with respect to this figure, now next figure, see what this figure will explain about the fork system called process creation. So we will see one example of fork system call. Fork call access the fork service in the Unix which create the new complete copy of main program. Okay, so in the initial impression it will take some time to understand, but slowly and steadily you concentrate on my sentence, then you will come to know what is the process creation and how this fork system call is executing. See, now I will start. Unix create the new child process by using fork system call. That is the first statement. Second, a new program which is an exact copy of the parent program, okay, including all its data and code areas as they exist right now as a current process for main which is running. Okay, next, if the current process, that is the code for main, is P25, suppose the current process ka naam hai P25, which is a parent process, then the new process, say P50, which is a child process, is created, which is exactly like the P25, which contains all the registers, data values, etc., are same. That is not a fresh copy of main, but the copy of this process as a new process. Okay, I said that in the initial impression it is difficult to understand, lekin आपको ये इंफॉर्मेशन याद रखनी पड़ेगी या अंडरस्टैंड करनी पड़ेगी कि जो कुछ न्यू प्रोसेस आप क्रिएट कर रहे हैं, आप मतलब यूनिक्स सिस्टम क्रिएट करने वाले हैं, दैट प्रोसेस इज हैविंग ऑल द रजिस्टर्स एंड द डेटा वैल्यूज ऑफ इट्स पेरेंट प्लस प्लस इट्स ओन डेटा वैल्यूज एंड इट्स ओन न्यू रजिस्टर्स दैट ऑल्सो बी देयर. तो इसका एक एनालॉजिकल एग्जांपल मैं देना चाहता हूँ. एनालॉजी इज दैट टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस थिंग्स, सी द चाइल्ड इज हैविंग ऑल द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ हिज पेरेंट. यस और नो? चाइल्ड इज हैविंग ऑल द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ हिज पेरेंट प्लस his own characteristics. समझ में आ रहा है आपको? चाइल्ड मतलब नॉर्मल ह्यूमन बीइंग, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट ह्यूमन बीइंग. सो द न्यू बॉर्न बेबी इज हैविंग ऑल द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ हिज पेरेंट प्लस ही इज हैविंग इट्स ओन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. गॉट इट? सो सेम थिंग इज रिटन हियर. वॉट एवर द रजिस्टर्स एंड वॉट एवर द डेटा वैल्यूज and whatever the characteristics of the parent process are equally applicable to the child process plus additional characteristics of its parent of its child. Okay, so samajh mein aaya aapko? So this thing is very important to understand how the child process is created and what are its characteristics. Okay, now very important next point. Okay, see, related to the fourth system called. Next point is, okay, see, set up the call stack for newly created child process P50 to make appear that P50 has been executed into 4 call and is about to return from 4 with the return value of 0. Okay, now here very important point is whenever the fourth system call is executed, it returns 2 value. See here, you keep in mind, this is the only one function in the Unix, or it is the only one function which return 2 value. This returns 2 value. Agar aapne abhi C language padhte hai, aapne C language mein function likhe honge, the function returns a single value. Yes or no? Every function return the single value. X से ज्यादा value function return नहीं कर सकता. लेकिन fourth system called is having an exception. Fourth system can return 2 value. This is a very important point to be note that fourth system call can return 2 value. Okay. I will tell you what are these 2 values. But right now you keep in your mind, जब आप fourth system called execute करते हैं, तो 2 value return होते हैं. First value is 0. First value is 0, which is returned to child process, which is returned to child process. And second value is non-zero, which is returned to the parent process. ये चीज आपको समझ में आई क्या? What I am saying? Okay. Fork returns 2 value. First is 0. 0 is returned to the child itself, and non-zero is returned to the parent. समझ में आया आपको? This is very important. ना ये आपको पूरे सेमिस्टर में आपको process creation is the very important topic. ये आपको हमेशा याद रखना पड़ेगा कि whenever the fork create the child process, so it returns 2 value. First value is 0. 0 is returned to the child process. Second value is non-zero. Non-zero value is returned to the parent process. Okay, yahan tak samajh mein aaya? Abhi next point. Next point kya hai? Ki ye non-zero value kya hai? Non-zero value jo parent process ko return ho rahi hai. What is this value? What is this value? क्या रहेगा आपका ओपिनियन क्या है? What will be the value? What will be this value? Non-zero value. What will be this non-zero value? No idea? Clear? Don't worry, I will tell you. Then kya kaam hai ne ki whenever the child process is created, child process created, it returns 2 value. Matlab fork returns 2 value. First value is 0. 0 will be returned to child process and non-zero will be returned to parent process. So mera question kya tha ki what is the non-zero value?
non-zero value is nothing but the process ID of child process. समझ में आया आपको? Non-zero value is the process ID of child process that is returned to the parent process. तो ये अभी natural है ना कि जो child process create हुई है उसका जो ID है वो parent को मालूम चाहिए. इसीलिए for क्या करता है? For return करता है उसका ID back to parent. समझ में आया यहाँ तक? कितने लोगों को समझ में आया? You can send the message in the chat box. Those who understood, okay? Yes. Don't say only yes. I want that this is the very important phenomena for creation of process. Okay? So that you should understood thoroughly. आपको पहली चीज क्या समझ में आना चाहिए कि हाउ यूनिक्स क्रिएट द प्रोसेस. यूनिक्स क्रिएट द प्रोसेस यूजिंग फोर्क सिस्टम कॉल. इतना आपको समझ में आया? सेकंड सिस्टम, सेकंड स्टेटमेंट आपको याद रखना चाहिए कि फोर्क सिस्टम कॉल रिटर्न्स टू वैल्यू. फर्स्ट वन, जीरो वैल्यू टू द चाइल्ड प्रोसेस and non-zero value to the parent process. Non-zero value is the ID, process ID, process identification of the child process that is returned to the parent process so that the parent can know who is the child. Yes, parent ko malum hona chahiye ki what is the ID of child. That's why that ID is returned to the parent process. This is the only one system called. ये general knowledge का question भी है. This can be asked in your gate examination. This can be asked in any technical interview. This can be asked in any interview that which is the system called which can return two value. So there is only one system called fork system call which returns two value. First one is zero. Second one is non-zero. Keep in mind. Okay, this is very important. समझ में आया आपको? Okay. If anybody is having any doubt, you can raise your question here. You can ask your question, doubts, your queries in the chat box, or you can unmute yourself and you can ask on the mic also. Any doubt, query, clarification you want about process creation? No doubt? That means you understood all things. Or if you are having any doubts, then ask your doubts. Nobody is having any doubt. Yes, Prathamesh is asking something that if multiple child process are created, then every child process creates a child of its own. Multiple child process are created, then every child process create a child of its means you want to talk about nested creation, nested na, multiple means nested means a parent create a child nested, correct? Okay, so that this is also possible, whatever you are saying that is possible, and we are going to implement one assignment, one program, that a parent creates a child and child create another child and that third child also create a fourth child. So that program is there in your syllabus. We will implement that program surely. Okay, so that is true, whatever you are saying, the multiple child process are created, then every child process create a child of its. Yes, absolutely right, this is it. Okay, that is called as a nested creation, nested creation. Okay, एंड एक अलग मीनिंग भी निकलता है आपके क्वेश्चन का कि मल्टीपल मीन्स वन पेरेंट कैन क्रिएट अ मल्टीपल चाइल्ड, दैट इज ऑल्सो ट्रू, वन पेरेंट कैन क्रिएट अ मल्टीपल चाइल्ड, दैट इज ऑल्सो ट्रू, दैट वी हैव टू राइट अ प्रोग्राम. सी हियर, क्रिएटिविटी मैटर्स, क्रिएटिविटी, आपका लॉजिक डेवलपमेंट, आपका क्रिएशन, आपकी कैपेबिलिटी, इम्प्लीमेंटेशन करने का तरीका, ये जो कुछ आप यूज करेंगे सी लैंग्वेज प्रोग्राम में, ये सब इम्प्लीमेंटेशन आप कर सकते हैं. आप मल्टीपल चाइल्ड भी क्रिएट कर सकते हैं, आप नेस्टेड चाइल्ड भी क्रिएट कर सकते हैं, दिस ऑल थिंग्स आर पॉसिबल, ओनली यू हैव टू डेवलप योर लॉजिक, एंड वी आर हैविंग वन प्रोग्राम्स दैट वी विल डिस्कस इन द लैबोरेटरी सेशन वेयर. यस, श्रद्धा इज सेइंग दैट गिव एग्जांपल, टेल एग्जांपल. यस, सो नाउ यू कैन सी एग्जांपल मीन्स suppose now a process is there, you take any process like addition of numbers, okay, addition of numbers, or mathematical operations, okay, mathematical operations. So a parent process is what, you are having a n numbers and you are two numbers, you are having a two numbers, a first child will perform addition, second child will perform multiplication, third child will perform division, and fourth child will perform your last operation, subtraction. Okay, so this can be one example. Okay, as a part of program, I am saying, as a part of program, you can create a program like this, and then whenever the first child executes the addition will be returned to parent. Second child perform the multiplication, multiplication will be returned to the parent. Okay, like this a program can be implemented in a C language using fork system call. Okay, where a process will be created. Our intention is not that to implement the addition subtraction karna hamara kaam nahi hai. We know that you can perform the addition subtraction very correctly. Lekin mujhe kya karna hai, mujhe aapko example batana hai ki example aap चाइल्ड प्रोसेस क्रिएट कर सकते हैं दैट विल परफॉर्म द एडिशन. तो अभी आप लोग चाइल्ड प्रोसेस क्रिएट करते हैं दैट विल परफॉर्म द मैट्रिक्स मल्टीप्लिकेशन, चाइल्ड प्रोसेस विल परफॉर्म अनदर चाइल्ड विल परफॉर्म द मैट्रिक्स सबट्रैक्शन, अनदर विल परफॉर्म फिबोनाची सीरीज, अनदर विल परफॉर्म द प्राइम नंबर क्रिएशन. सो लाइक दिस अ प्रोसेस कैन बी क्रिएटेड. प्रोसेस का मतलब क्या है, व्हाट इज मीन बाय प्रोसेस, टेल मी द डेफिनेशन ऑफ प्रोसेस वंस अगेन. Tell me the definition of process once again. What is mean by process? What is the process? So that you can understand the example. A process is the instance of program which is in execution. Correct. Absolutely right. So, जो कुछ आप create child process. Whatever the child process you are creating, that must be executing. समझ में आ रहा है आपको? So child process, newly created child process must execute something. ऐसा तो नहीं होता ना कि child create हुआ और वो कुछ perform नहीं कर रहा है. Child is always performing something. समझ में आ रहा है आपको? Child, newly created child should execute something. So ये करने के लिए आपको immediately you have to use another system call, that is
EXEC. EXEC stand for execute system call. Execute. EXEC. ये भी आपको बाद में बताने वाला हूँ मैं. Okay. So that is the second system call that you are going to learn. Okay. EXEC. So process. Okay. So are you satisfied with the example, Shraddha? Or anything more you want? Okay. About process ID, correct, very good. See, so process management is a very important function of the operating system. So process, ye sab aapka next article hai, process services of the operating system. Services of the operating system, ye next article mein aap padhne wale hai ki what are the services provided by operating system. So one of the services is process management. So process management mein kya hota hai ki process management mein जो नई प्रोसेस क्रिएट होती है, एवरी न्यू क्रिएटेड प्रोसेस इज अलोकेटेड विद द आईडी, प्रोसेस आईडी, उसे शॉर्टकट में कहते हैं पीआईडी. ईच एंड एवरी प्रोसेस इज हैविंग अ पीआईडी. पीआईडी स्टैंड फॉर प्रोसेस आईडी, यूनिक आईडी, व्हिच इज अ यूनिक आईडी, व्हिच इज नॉट रिपीटेड, व्हिच इज अ यूनिक आईडी टू ईच प्रोसेस. समझ में आया? Which is a unique ID to each process. New child process created, it is also having a ID. So, मैंने कहा कि the fork will return two values. One is the zero value and second is the non-zero. The non-zero value is the process ID. Parent को मालूम चाहिए कि process का number क्या है. मैंने जो process create की उसका number क्या है, ये parent को मालूम होने के लिए fork will return the process ID of the new child process. टू द पेरेंट प्रोसेस. समझ में आया? तो ये भी आपको वंस नेक्स्ट प्रैक्टिकल में मैं आपको सब कुछ कमांड लिनक्स कमांड में अवेलेबल है. लिनक्स कमांड्स आर अवेलेबल टू 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 डिस्प्ले द प्रोसेस आईडी एंड द आईडी ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी प्रोसेस व्हिच आर क्रिएटेड. ओके, प्रोसेस आईडी. राइट नाउ यू रिमेंबर दैट प्रोसेस आईडी इज द यूनिक आईडी व्हिच इज असाइन टू द ईच प्रोसेस व्हिच इज क्रिएटेड. So then again in the process management we will learn there is a process control block, PCB. PCB stand for process control block. So where all the process which are created that are stored. Okay. So this much is sufficient for this article, processing environment. Because if I explain all the things in the this exam in this article, then it will be difficult to understand. ये इंटरेस्टिंग है, नो डाउट अबाउट दैट. दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टू अंडरस्टैंड. लेकिन स्लोली स्लोली स्टेडली नाउ यू आर द बिगिनर्स. ओके, तो इस जो सेकंड बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक्स अपना मतलब द सेकंड हाई लेवल फीचर्स ऑफ द यूनिक्स इज प्रोसेसिंग एनवायरमेंट. इसमें आप इतना ही इंफॉर्मेशन अंडरस्टैंड करो कि व्हाट इज मीन बाय प्रोसेस, हाउ द प्रोसेस इज क्रिएटेड. So this is the example that creates the new process. Okay, एक sample example याद दिया है. Here now main function is written. Okay, and you see how the fork is executed. See, if fork is equal to zero, fork is equal to zero, then EXECL, that is execute system call, मैंने अभी कहा. And then wait, यहाँ पे और एक system call, तीन system call use किया यहाँ पे, तीन, four, EXECL and next one is the wait. समझ में कुछ समझ में आ रहा है क्या program देखने के बाद? Are you getting something? Okay, already our time is finished. Still two or three minutes we will continue. कुछ आपको या प्रोग्राम में प्रोग्राम के पास प्रोग्राम को देखने के बाद कुछ समझ में आ रहा है क्या? What is happening there? Fork देखो, fork. तो whenever the fork system called is encounter, तो operating system क्या करेगा? चाइल्ड प्रोसेस क्रिएट करेगा. ओके,
चाइल्ड प्रोसेस क्रिएट करेगा और क्या करेगा, दो वैल्यू रिटर्न करेगा, फर्स्ट वैल्यू इज जीरो। तो अभी प्रोग्राम में आप देख सकते हैं इफ फोर्क इज इक्वल टू जीरो, तो जीरो किसको रिटर्न होता है, जीरो वैल्यू इज रिटर्न टू चाइल्ड, करेक्ट। तो चाइल्ड इज द प्रोसेस ना, अभी जो न्यू प्रोसेस आपने क्रिएट की उसको आपको एग्जीक्यूट करना है ना, तो एग्जीक्यूट करने के लिए आपको नीचे जो सिस्टम कॉल दिया है execl, execl ये जो सिस्टम कॉल है वो दिया है नीचे। तो ये क्या करेगा, अभी इसके जो पैरामीटर है ये आपको मैं नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में एक्सप्लेन करूंगा, लेकिन अभी शॉर्टली एंड ब्रीफली आई विल टेल यू, ये execl क्या कर रहा है, यहाँ पे एक प्रोग्राम एग्जीक्यूट कर रहा है, कॉपी नाम है उसका, कॉपी जो अभी प्रीवियस स्लाइड में मैंने दिखाया था ना, कॉपी, ये कॉपी नाम का प्रोग्राम है। ये क्या करेगा, कॉपी नाम का प्रोग्राम ये execl एग्जीक्यूट करेगा, जो एक्चुअली कौन एग्जीक्यूट कर रहा है, न्यू क्रिएटेड चाइल्ड। आप पूछेंगे सर हाउ कैन यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट द न्यूली क्रिएटेड चाइल्ड प्रोसेस ही एग्जीक्यूट कर रहा है, न्यू प्रोसेस ही एग्जीक्यूट कर रहा है, ये आप 100% कैसे कह सकते हैं। तो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स हियर फोर्क इज इक्वल टू जीरो लिखा है यहाँ पे, इफ फोर्क इज इक्वल टू जीरो दैट मीन्स वट एवर द स्टेटमेंट वी आर राइटिंग दैट इज फॉर चाइल्ड प्रोसेस। जीरो वैल्यू किसको रिटर्न करता है, चाइल्ड को, और नॉन जीरो वैल्यू किसको जाती है, पेरेंट को। ओके, नॉन जीरो वैल्यू गोज टू द पेरेंट, जीरो वैल्यू गोज टू द चाइल्ड। तो चाइल्ड प्रोसेस विल एग्जीक्यूट द कॉपी प्रोग्राम। आई विल स्टॉप हियर, ओके, इफ यू कंटिन्यू एंड इफ यू डिस्कस मेनी मोर थिंग्स ऑन दिस देन प्रोबेबली इट इज डिफिकल्ट। इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल अगेन सी सम ऑफ द पॉइंट्स ऑफ द फोर्क and we will continue our next, that is the basic building block primitives, next article. Okay, I hope that all you understand about the processing environment, the second features of the Unix operating system. In the next lecture we will start the building block primitives. Till then I will stop here. Don't forget to go to the LMS, LMS mein jaakar aapko attendance dena hai abhi, LMS, go to the LMS and mark your attendance there. Now I will stop the session. Thank you very much for joining. Good day.